Good morning, good morning, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to our Sunday morning celebration. Let us begin, as all things do, with our opening affirmative prayer. There is only one presence, one power, one infinite intelligence that governs, guards, and guides. This presence is God, and we are one with this power. I know for each one of us that is gathered here together this morning in our sanctuary, and those tuned into this service on the World Wide Web, I know for each one of us truly an experience of joy, of open sharing, as we pool our consciousness in today's Sunday morning celebration. I know for our speaker, Reverend John, that he is truly a channel through which his message now flows easily and effortlessly, inspiring and uplifting each one of us who's tuned into this service. And I know that we leave from this gathering having taken a step upon that pathway of truth and enlightenment. And I know that every activity that takes place in this morning's celebration, our musicians, our music, every aspect of this service is now all in divine order. Everything that needs to happen happens at the right time and in the right way. And we truly give thanks for each other and give thanks for our sharing together. Feeling the fullness of this faith, I release this word to law, giving thanks that all this is already so. And so it is. And this morning, our inspirational reading comes to us from one of our past Science of Mind magazine. And it's a reading that says, gratitude for my good. Gratitude turns what we have into enough. And then the quote from Ernest Holmes is, the secret of spiritual power is a consciousness of one's union with the whole and the availability of good. We are one with a universal creativeness, which is the God of theology, the spirit of mysticism, the reality of philosophy, and the principle of science. God is accessible to all people. And that is from Can We Talk to God? The good that God is literally flows through this universe, this world, and us. Yet, so often we forget that we are in the midst of it right now. And it is in the midst of us right now. Today, let us focus on the good that is present in our lives and that has emerged into our awareness through this work. It is said that what we focus on tends to expand in our awareness and therefore expand into our lives. This has been repeatedly that we find our way into gratitude for as much as we possibly can, and this expansive consciousness makes welcome more of this good for us. Keep giving thanks, keep seeing the good and praising it, raising it, claiming it. It is in this action that we feel a greater sense of happiness and connection to all life. Gratitude is magical in the efforts that we are making to improve our lives individually and collectively. Gratitude also magnifies our awareness. We can be in the midst of some location or environment we habitually experience, and suddenly our grateful heart helps us to see that situation, condition, or person in a brand new light. We see what we had not seen before, we feel what we had not felt before, and become what we could not have become before. Gratitude is transformative. Let us be transformed daily. And the affirmation says, the good of the universe is abundantly present in my life right now. I see it, I claim it, and I accept it. And so it is.
And so it is.
Friends, please join me in the praise song, and I'll invite you to stand. Remain standing for the prayer of our center, and that's on the flyer in your program or on the screen for those of you joining us on a Facebook Live. Together, the Temple of Light Center for Spiritual Living is a sacred field embodying our spiritual community from which the Christ peace, love, and joy emanate to touch, to heal, to bless, to prosper, and to liberate anyone who comes into contact with it in any way. The light of the Christ illumines us, our center, and our environment. Our spiritual community is filled with and surrounded by the presence of God and is growing from strength to strength. The power of God expands our consciousness of truth, guiding us ceaselessly along the paths of wisdom, spiritual growth, unfoldment, and attainment. We are blessed, and to God be the honor and the glory forever. And so it is. And now I'll be lighting the candle on behalf of all the youth of the world, and I just ask you to indulge me a minute. As we remain standing, we'll do our mission song after. And now, let me first bless the youth of the world. We love you. We appreciate you. We salute the Christ in you. We see you as shining lights onto your world. God is blessing you now. And so it is. And now, our mission song.
Love light, the temple of light.
The temple of light, the temple of light, the temple of light. We are a people with a vision, one spirit on a mission. Spirit on a mission to touch, to heal, to bless, to prosper, to love and liberate anyone who comes into contact with us anytime, night or day.
Seated, and thank you, Angela. I heard some of Maestro Uncle Noel coming out a moment ago in that playing. Thank you so much. Yes. And now for the announcements. For today, Sunday, October 18th, our flowers this morning is a gift from October celebrants, exquisitely arranged by Mrs. Glynis Young, and I think you would agree that they are beautiful. Thank you, Glynis, and all the October folk that is celebrating a birthday this month. And I'm sure you know whose birthday is most imminent. You are invited to spend a few quiet moments in the garden with Reverend John every Monday morning at 6 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Facebook Live. And please join us again on Facebook Live for a spiritual mind healing service on Tuesday, October 20th at 6 p.m. And this week, yours truly, I'm Jennifer Livingston, incidentally, didn't give you my name earlier, will be the speaker. Sunday, October 25th, will be our Practitioner Sunday celebration at 9, and Practitioner Carol Campbell, hosted by Practitioner Vance Gardner, will bring us the message. Please join us again for Tuesday and Sunday of this next week. Please remember, if you intend to attend services here at the temple, to call our office at 876-946-2230 and make a reservation to attend in person. As you know, congregants who attend must wear a face mask and observe the prescribed protocols. Please also remember to maintain physical distancing and to leave the premises as quickly as possible after the service. And if you can't bless us with your presence on a Sunday, you can still be with us in consciousness as services continue to be live streamed here on Facebook Live. For our new members, and here is an invitation. If you have been attending services regularly or online, you are invited to become a registered member of our spiritual community. The only prerequisite is your hunger and thirst after righteousness and your attendance of at least one unit of Science of Mind classes. So as Reverend John would say, your assignment is to prayerfully ask Spirit's confirmation that this is a time for you to stand up and be counted. So that is an invitation for those of you online and here in the sanctuary. If you are ready to make that move to become a member, please let us know by contacting the office. Classes. Science of Mind classes begin on Tuesday, October 27, with the Principles of Successful Living from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. on Zoom. The facilitator will be Reverend Michael Record. And then on Thursday mornings, beginning on October 29 from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., join Reverend John Scott right here in the sanctuary for Soulful Connecting, which is the continuation of the series which began before the pandemic. So remember, there are two opportunities to join us for classes beginning on October 27th. We do look forward to you participating. And also on Thursday evenings, Reverend Sonia Davidson and Reverend Ann Chand is offering a new series, titled Wholeness, from 7 to 9 p.m. on Zoom. Classes for non-residents of Jamaica cost U.S. $16 for non-members and U.S. $10 for members payable through our PayPal or our Facebook account. And for our Jamaican residents, classes cost $1,600 for non-members and $1,200 for members, payable at the office or to our savings account, that's 20941 at the Bank of Nova Scotia. Please register, of course, by calling ahead to the office at 876-946-2230. So my friends, you have more than enough opportunities to avail yourselves of classes here at the temple, so do find an opportunity and one that's convenient for you. Now we are offering classes online as well, which is awesome. Due to COVID-19 restrictions and her personal wishes, there will be a private interment of our beloved Grace Brown. Her family has requested a tribute, and Reverend John Scott has sent it on behalf of the Temple family. So that's will be our farewell to one of our long-standing ushers here at the Temple, Grace Brown. My friends, Summit 2020. Michael Bridge beautifully says, "When our eyes see our hands doing the work of our hearts, the circle of creation is completed inside us. The doors of our souls fly open, and love steps forth to heal everything inside." End quote. Our summit is a long-cherished idea whose time has come. It is a vision of a community of kindred spirits coming together for a single purpose, to work towards increasing the vibration of love and the spirit of oneness within it, the wider community, and by extension, our world. Together, we will engage in conversation and spiritual fellowship and bond to strengthen our role as ambassadors of peace and instruments of healing in a world that works for everyone. You are a valuable unit within the whole. Please consider helping to defray the cost of the summit by contributing cash. No amount is too small or too large. We know that as Spirit is ensuring all the requirements for this transformative event are met, we thank you in advance for your consciousness of giving. Together, we can get great things done. And I do appeal to you to assist us with this event. So yesterday, the pre-summit meeting was a glorious sharing of our vision, mission, and goals. And so if you missed it, our next event is on October 30th at 3 p.m. and you can still register. So please join us in shaping the future of this, our beloved Temple of Light, and see you all at the summit. My friends, prayer support. We continue to respond with prayer to the challenges of this special time. You can listen to an inspiring prayer by calling our prayer line, 876-978-1167. And if you wish to speak in person with one of our ministers, they may be reached at 876-286-0907 from 8 a.m. to 12 midnight, Mondays to Fridays. And you can also phone in your prayer requests into our offices at 876-92-76145 or 876-946-2230, as well as you can email your requests to Temple of Light at cwjamaica.com. You can also drop off your prayer requests, your tithes, and your offerings, or set appointments to meet with a practitioner. And if you so feel and you're moved to support our ministry of love and light, your loving gifts may be transferred to our savings account, Bank of Nova Scotia. The account number again, 20941, and it's the New Kingston branch. And the viewers who join us on Facebook Live, please visit the home tab of the Facebook page, where you can find the link to our PayPal donate button in the top post. Friends, if you are worshiping with us in person, there is a basket, as you can observe, on either side of the podium in which you can place your love offerings as you exit the sanctuary. There are so many opportunities for you to give and to give, and we look forward to your continued support of this ministry. This concludes the announcements. Now please join us in the singing of the hymn, Praise to the Lord Almighty on page 3 of your program, or in the screen, or on the screen if you're watching us on Facebook Live. Please stand. And now we've come to that time in our service where I get to introduce our speaker for the morning. On this, our Heroes Weekend, I am sure that he's here to bring a message that will inspire, that will continue to uplift, and most importantly, that will help us to move forward in this journey as a community. So please help me to welcome to our podium our speaker, our beloved, our pastor, Reverend John Scott, the beloved. Welcome, Reverend John.
Good morning, family. Good morning, world. Good morning, God. Praise to the Lord. And you know, when you see that word Lord in the Bible, you can substitute the word law. Praise to the law, because it governs everything, and we live by that law. It is perfect and impersonal, and once we know how to use it, it works in our lives and in our affairs to the honor and glory of that which created all things out of itself. So good morning and welcome to the Temple of Light Center for Spiritual Living in beautiful Jamaica. It is my joy to speak with you this morning on something that has been in my heart, but it's particularly, I think, relevant on this weekend in which Jamaica celebrates its national heroes. Because you have what it takes, you. Next time you look in the mirror, just say this to yourself: I have what it takes to be a hero. Can we say that together? I have what it takes to be a hero. You know, for a relatively small and very young nation, we have produced sons and daughters who have excelled in every sphere of human endeavor, and our people have impacted the world in ways that are entirely out of proportion with our size. No? Absolutely. Just take one of our six national heroes, the most honorable Marcus Mosiah Garvey. Born in St. Anne's Bay in 1887, in his short 52-year lifespan, he became one of the world's most influential leaders. His brilliant oratory, his grasp of philosophy, and his newspaper, Negro World, founded in 1920, brought him millions of followers all over the world. Actually, legend has it that Garvey's organization was and remains the largest international organization of all times. Those of us who claim Jamaica as home can truly pride ourselves in the dialect pun, Jamaica. Jah, the King of Kings, the Lord, created us out of itself in the image and likeness of its beauty and its love and its joy and its wonder and amazement. And when Jamaica is your home, either because you live here or because your heart is here, there is something special that happens inside of you. And I'm not quite sure what it is. You know, there are Jamaicans who have been abroad for years and years and years, and they say, you know, I'm coming home one day, and if I make the transition and leave this plane, physical plane, bring home the body. They want, part of us never leaves this little island. Part of us is really here full time. Garvey wrote, and I quote, "A people without the knowledge of their past history, origin, and culture is like a tree without roots." And you know what happens when a tree doesn't have very, very deep roots. Unquote. You see, Garvey's passion and purpose was to change the consciousness of people. And so I think he would be resonating with what we are doing right now in working at looking at our own movement, the Temple of Light Center for Spiritual Living and the Centers for Spiritual Living movement generally, and what our role is in a transforming world, because Garvey, and in fact all of the eras that I can think of throughout the ages, have been about transformation. So I've titled my encouragement as I started, "You have what it takes to be a hero." Mariah Carey, in her beautiful song, Hero, reminds us, and I quote, "And then a hero comes along," I won't sing it, "with the strength to carry on. And you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong. And you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you." End of quote. Yes, friends, a hero lies in you, in each of us. You have what it takes to be a hero. We may not all be powerful orators capable of capturing the attention of others and inspiring millions, as Garvey did, to reach for greatness, but we are all able to draw on the inner power and guidance of God. And so, you know, when Jesus was asked about his healing power, he replied that he of himself really didn't do anything. It was the Father within him, the power within him that he called Father, the same power that is within each and every one of us. It is that power and that law that we praise this morning in our hymn that does the work. The Sufi mystics believe that there are two sources of power we can tap. The first is a physical source located in our adrenal glands. This is the fight or flight system wired into us, which can give a mother the strength to lift a truck off her child, or it just is that energy. You know, you get it sometimes when you need to get the house in order because your mother-in-law has just phoned to say she's on her way over. And you move like lightning to get everything in order and to get yourself ready so you are presentable and looking wonderful before she arrives. It's that energy. You know, it fires you up and you can accomplish things. But all of us know if you draw on that energy too often, you can suffer from burnout. It's not good to live at that level of vibration permanently. But the second source of energy is non-physical. And that source, my friends, is spiritual. It doesn't take anything out of you. When you call on it, it is even mightier than the adrenal force, but it doesn't deplete you. You can't deplete it. A New Thought author, Joan Borisenko, says of this power within us that we can call on, and I quote, "Like the sun that rises in the east, it is renewed each day. It can't run out, and you can't burn out," unquote. She notes further that the most important factor in becoming a channel of divine energy, and this I found this very interesting, the most important factor in becoming a channel, I like the word channel because it means that it's flowing through you for this energy, that factor is humility. And so I like to think of myself as a humble hero. A hero that looks for the hero in other people. A hero that sees beyond human frailty and human foibles and human mistakes to the truth of every person we meet. And when you have that humility within you, you think, wow. You know, at the prison at Tower Street, one of the warders said to one of my classes, you know, I'm doing time with you. Yeah, I'm in here with you. And it just made the whole class warm to him in a way that people who are incarcerated don't normally warm to those who are responsible for keeping them in prison. So why is humility such an important aspect of your hero's journey then? Humility may be defined as the absence of pride, and pride in turn can be construed to mean an inflated opinion of oneself. Conceit, if you prefer. I often tell the story, and I've told you before, of an early lesson I had in humility and the danger of pride. I was 10, and I had just received a much wanted bicycle. And one of the few things I could do at age 10, better than my brother, age 14, was ride with no hands, you know? Hands off the handlebars. So I was whizzing up and down the driveway, no hands, while my brother, who couldn't give a hoot, was seated on the veranda with our blind grandmother reading the Bible to her. And as I hit the bottom of the driveway, thank God I was out of sight of them. The blasted bicycle skidded in some sand, and in Jamaica, when you do us overhead, we say, "We kin pupalik. A kin pupalik," and crepe up the hole of my knee. So, you know, I dusted off my bruised pride and thanking God that they never saw me, you know. And as I was passing, remember grandmother was quite unable to see. She said dryly, and I quote, "Pride goeth before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall," end quote. Tell me how the devil she knew that I had just dropped. And my brother intoned in his most professorial and stentorian voice, Proverbs 16, verse 18. Now, I didn't know much about one mind at those times, but it is quite ironic that the very verse that he was reading from, that he quoted, referred to my mishap. And I just thought, yeah, even at that young age, don't, as we say in Jamaica now, don't big up yourself and to make yourself look better or bigger or nicer or brighter than anyone else. So I'm reminded of an old Russian fable that tells of an infamous robber who was a master of disguise. And he managed to elude the police for many, many years through the use of very elaborate disguises. His latest one was that of an Orthodox priest. But he got word that the police were closing in. They were on to his latest disguise. And so he was, you know, looking to find a way to escape. And he came upon an inn where there was a peasant who was in a drunken stupor. Quite drunk, he had had too much vodka and was flat out. And so the robber changed his prelate's robes for the peasant's garb and left him there in a drunken stupor and went on his way, again evading the police. In the morning when the peasant awoke, he was kind of puzzled to find himself wearing a priest's robes. And he thought to himself, either I'm a peasant, and the fact that I'm wearing a priest's robe is a terrible mistake, or I have somehow, I can't remember being a peasant, and it's really just a bad dream. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go to the cathedral, and I'm going to look at the holy books. And if I can read them, I will know I am a priest. And if I can't, I'll know I'm a peasant. So he went down to the church and opened the holy books and, of course, couldn't read a thing. So he said, I know. I really am a priest. You see, the fact that I can't read the holy books, well, the other priests can't read it either. They just pretend. So I'll pretend that I'm a priest too. My friends, the teaching known as the science of mind and spirit eliminates the need for pretense and leads us to the recognition of our true nature, and that cannot be hidden or disguised by the masks that we are obliged to wear in this particular time. Because your divinity, the truth of your being, shines through you, no matter what you're wearing, and no matter how, what you are doing. When you are being the divine being that you are, it must shine through and bless and touch and inspire and uplift everyone with whom you come into contact. So as we seek to uncover the hero within, it is critical that we become aware of this true self. Raymond Charles Barker, one of the first New Thought writers to whom I was exposed, explains it this way, and I quote, "Your consciousness, your thinking, feeling process of life, is what you are. You did not create it, nor can you stop it. You are it. You are consciousness." So I like to put in the word state. Life is a state of consciousness. And therefore, one has to look inside oneself, as Mariah Carey said. You will find the hero, and behind that hero, or within that hero, you will find the consciousness of humility, the consciousness of love, the consciousness of service, the consciousness of selflessness, the consciousness of being a light for God in the world. Let us affirm, I have the consciousness of the divine presence within me. Together? I have the consciousness of the divine presence within me. Yesterday at our pre-summit meeting, after a few technical glitches with connectivity, we had a meaningful conversation and drew some important conclusions regarding our core values, vision, and mission. We want everyone who has ever been touched by the Temple of Light to be part of the spiritual exercise which we have dubbed Summit 2020. So your assignment is to register, if you haven't already done so, for October 30 and 31st and November 7. And 8. 6 and 7. Thank you. November 6 and 7. If you have already registered, yay, well done. Now don't forget to join us for our opening ceremony at 3 p.m. on October 30th. And all this week, the other part of your assignment is set your intention to see the hero in everyone you meet, even if they are not evidencing the divine potential that you know is within them. For there is always that within each person that is greater, that is more beautiful and more joyous than the mistakes they have made. I found that this has been a big lesson for me in the program that we have run for the past 8 years at the prison. That Change Your Thinking, Change Your Life program really is a template for change, for transformation, to use the word. And Jennifer used it in her inspirational reading this morning, too, from the Santa Man magazine. Let us be transformed. St. Paul said, be ye renewed by what? The transforming of your mind. So this business of transformation is really in the forefront of my mind, and I'm hoping that you will give it some thought, too. Butterworth cites the case of an ex-convict who in his rediscovered self chose to be known as Alva Romanes. He had gone astray early in life, living many years on the shady side of the law, and ended up serving a long stretch in prison. Like many of the participants in our program, which has now been interrupted by the pandemic, but I know it's going to resume, and I know that we have touched many, many, many lives, and many lives have been transformed by the work that we have done in the male and the female prisons. So Romanes put some of his feelings into poetry. And Butterworth notes, he says it's not great poetry, but the ideas contained in it are divine and are so beautiful. And so I'd like to share this poem with you, written in the hopeless atmosphere of a cell block. I am not the brood of the dust and sod, nor a shuttled thread in the loom of fate, but the child divine of the living God, with eternity for my life's estate. I am not the sport of a cosmic night, nor a thing of chance that has grown to man. I am not but a deathless soul on my upward flight, and my father's heir in his wondrous plan. As I weigh the suns on the rim of space, who can care to doubt of my destiny? Who can fence my feet within time and space as I search the worlds of infinity? I am man, the son of the one most high. I am man and one with the life divine. I am Lord of earth and of sea and sky, and behold, the powers of heaven are mine. I am man the chosen and man the free, and it matters not what I may have been, for I walk erect through eternity to the far off goal that is yet unseen. With unswerving faith on the coming day, I have turned my course from the things of time. And with Jesus, my brother, to point the way, I have found my place in the life sublime. End of that poem. As some would say, this man is a criminal. I wonder about him and about many of the inmates who have blessed me with their insight and creativity and love. Did his soul, I wonder, choose the experience? You know, life, I think, prepares us for itself. You know, would Paul have been the founder of Christianity, and if he had not first started off as a persecutor of Christians? We never know, my friends, what life plan we have made, perhaps even before we came to this plane, for how we are going to work out and rediscover the destiny, the divinity, and the delight of living that was meant to be. Perhaps sometimes we choose a rocky road. Sometimes the journey is easier for some than for some. But all of us are on a journey. And I think when I think of the metaphor of the summit and climbing the mountain, I remind myself that mountaineers, as they seek to reach the peak experience of their quest, they are tethered together for safety. And so as a community, I see ourselves being tethered together by the divine love that created each and every one of us out of itself and that sustains us in its own perfection at our levels of unfoldment and understanding. In his magnum opus, The Science of Mind, Ernest Holmes writes, and I quote, "There is hidden within the mind of man a divinity. There is incarnated in you and me that is, which is an incarnation of God. There is no revelation higher than the realization of the divinity within us. Let us affirm, I am a spiritual being, a hero, whole and free, together. I am a spiritual being, a hero, whole and free. I am the master of my destiny. I am the master of my destiny. To your neighbor, say, you are a spiritual being and a hero, whole and free. Happy Heroes Day. You are a spiritual being, a hero, whole and free. Happy Heroes Day. My friends, you are, each and every one of you, a radiant and beautiful and joyful spiritual being. You are the master of your destiny. You are the stuff of which Heroes is made. I revere you, I love you, I honor you. On this Heroes weekend, when Jamaica celebrates all those upon whose shoulders we stand, happy Heroes Day and Namaste. And it is my joy now to invite to the podium our very own Janet Morris Henry, who will bless us with a beautiful interpretation of the Lord's Prayer. Janet?
Thank you, Reverend John. Morning, everyone.
Morning, Jan. Thank you, Janet, and thank you, Angela.
Wonderful. Would you please stand and join me for the prayer of Jamaica? And here's something nice to do. If you are at home, please stand also with us. Stand with us for this wonderful prayer of Jamaica. It's on the flyer in your program and on the screen. Together. The radiant light of God's love is now flowing through us and from us to everything and everyone it touches. The eternal light of God's love now completely fills, covers, and surrounds our island, Jamaica. The glowing intensity of the light of God's love now interpenetrates and awakens within the hearts and minds of our countrymen and women the truths of life which set free. The light of God's love is growing and growing in intensity in the hearts and minds of mankind everywhere. Love, health, harmony, goodwill, peace, uprightness, integrity, joy, prosperity, kindness, and our oneness under God are now established, and so it is. And if you're in the sanctuary, friends, please take your love offering in your hand. And if you're watching us on the World Wide Web, just before you go to the home tab on Facebook, let us bless our love offering by saying, lovingly I give, joyfully I receive. Be thou fruitful, increase and multiply. Bless, prosper, and enrich everyone whom you touch, and replenish all of my financial affairs. Thank you, Father. And so it is. Let us sing the peace song. Yes, there is peace.
Yes, there is peace on earth, and yes, it begins with me. Yes, there is peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be with God as a power. Family, all are we. Yes, we walk with each other in perfect harmony. Yes, peace begins with me. Yes, this is the moment now. With every step I make, yes, this is my joyous vow, my vow to take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Yes, there is peace on earth, and yes, it begins with me.
And with this peace resonating in our very souls, we bring this celebration of life, of the heroes within, to a close, knowing that life is endless, and that wherever we go, we take the consciousness of the humble hero, beholding that in each person we meet on life's path, allowing our light to shine that others may see and seek to find that same light within themselves. It is all and only God, and therefore it must be good. And so with hearts full of gratitude and overflowing with love, we step forth into this new week to honor and glorify God as we give thanks that this is so, and so it is. Have a wonderful week.
Yeah.
Yes, this is my dream.